Hey Foxes, I'm Bonnie.
And I'm Gavin.
And welcome back to World News.
In Indonesia, a volcano erupted, claiming a known 14 lives and left dozens more injured. At least 11 villages have been coated in ash, leaving 56 people injured in those villages. More rescue attempts are ongoing.
In 2013, a French climber found a box full of emeralds, sapphires, and rubies that had been buried for decades. It is believed that the box belonged to someone on board an Indian plane that crashed half a century earlier. The mountaineer turned the box into the police when it was found in 2013, as required by French law. He was rewarded on Sunday for turning the box in with half of the precious gems that were in the box.
Over in Belgium, two hippos in a zoo have been taken into quarantine after testing positive for COVID. It is unclear how the hippos got the COVID, but the animals are reported to be doing well. The hippos' enclosure has been closed off and their handlers have tested negative for COVID.
In Mexico, archaeologists have uncovered an altar dating back to the 16th century near Mexico City. The altar dates back to the time after the Spanish conquest of the Aztec capital. Experts say it was located in a courtyard inside of a home of an Aztec family who would have used it to honor the dead. The altar contains a pot with human ashes.
In Honduras, the country's first female president has just been voted into office. Xiomara Castro previously ran into office three times before being elected into office last week.
Over in Australia, one of the largest banks of the country, Westpac, has admitted to breaking the law after it was hit with six lawsuits by regulators over its poor treatment of customers, including charging fees to dead people. It will pay $81 million in penalties, subject to court approval. The bank will also hand $57 million of compensation to its customers.
In India, animal rescuers were called to a village to rescue a 4-foot venomous speckled cobra with its head stuck inside the opening at the top of a discarded empty can. The rescuers were able to save the cobra and the snake's minor injuries with antibiotic spray before releasing it back into the wild.
In Denmark, 31 customers and employees spent the night at an IKEA while public transportation was stopped due to a snowstorm. The kitchen staff made hot chocolate for everyone while they watched Christmas movies and soccer together.
That's all the news we have for you this week, Foxes.
Stay informed.